Wealth is something that seems to be changing. You know, it's evolving in terms of what is wealth and what does wealth look like in today's modern world. Once upon a time, $1 million seemed to be the, you know, the be all and end all. If someone would be wealthy, if they had $1 million, that seemed to be the magic number. But what we now know, you know, $1 million in today's world isn't going to get you very far. What does wealth look like today? How much do you need to be either having assets or in cash or in income in order to be considered wealthy today?
I literally did a seminar about 2 hours ago, and one of the questions said to people was, how many people at school that wanted to marry a millionaire? Like, you'd be so happy if you managed to marry a millionaire or a millionaireess. What if you marry one now? Oh, he's poor. I'm going to have to go out to work to support my other half because he's only a millionaire. So, look, I think it depends where you come from around the world, but I would say a reasonable millionaire these days is probably 10 mil.
Right.
And that's of assets, whether it's net assets or total assets, I think that's roughly the number. And look, I'd say a good income these days is probably 250 to 500 grand. Now, there's some people out there that might be on 50 or 100 thinking you're full of it, whatever, like 100 grand, you should be grateful. And I firmly believe in that. Most of my portfolio, I earn less than 80,000 a year as an accountant.
Yeah, right.
So I talk about money and wealth all the time, but I'm not actually hung up on it. And so I think a lot of people that actually know me say, well, you're actually quite down to earth. We see this kind of persona and it's all money, 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 but it's not with me. Like my car's, I was at 12 years old. I live in a rental, so I don't even own my own home and I don't want to own my own home. So I talk about these numbers flippantly, but I think whether you earn 100 grand or 500 or a million, you can be a lot wealthier on a 100 grand salary.
Mm.
Because the people at 500 and a million, they assume they're going to be wealthy because they're successful. But in reality, they do nothing with their money. Whereas I think the 100 grand person or the 50 grand person thinks, hey, I don't earn a lot, I'm poor, and they get their money working harder.
Is that
right? I saw this in my 30s at Deloitte's.